let's define the search problem first. So the search problem means that we have a set of n values and we must check if a value v is a member of this set. We return true if it is, and we return false if it isn't. We can also say that we accept v or we reject v depending on if it is or if it isn't member of this set. So a variant, a slight extension that is more useful, is that we have not only a single value, but we have storing a key value tuple. And now we try to figure out if a specific key is member of the set, and if it is, we return the value. Otherwise, we return basically null. So a primitive data structure could be considered to look like this tuple here. We have a key and a value. An example about student information would be that we want to store the student details like name, telephone number, and whatever you have. And the key should be the student ID number, like 4711. Now, when we have such a single key value tuple, we want to store many of them, right? So one data structure to do this would be an array. And so we want to store, in this example, n many elements. So we would have as a first element the key 0 and value 0 as key 1. We have the next and so on until we have stored all these n key value tuples. And now the question is, when we get a specific key, k, right, we have to find the corresponding value if it exists. And if it doesn't, right, we have to return null. So how long does it take if you have n elements to find out if k is in these keys? And for this kind of analysis, it's important to figure out how long it would take to do one comparison. So if you have one key, like key 0, and you compare it with k, we assume this naively this takes just one unit of time. Right? So if you do two comparison, well, it takes 2 time units. So how long would it take to compare all those n elements? Now, spend like 3 minutes thinking about this problem, how you would formulate and code it in C. And after you've done it, you thought about it, I will reveal the solution. So pause the video now. Welcome back. Here is now a solution. So one approach would be that we use a for loop to check every element in our array. And we compare basically the key. Here we assume it's an integer key. So if the key is identical at this location in the array, then k, then we return the value. And if we iterated through all of the elements, we know we haven't found it, so we can return null. Right, so if you do a small analysis of this algorithm, you would find out that first of all, the key we search can be on any position here, right? It could be here, it could be the first element, it could be the last one, and it could not exist. So we need basically to check all the elements, but if we find a matching one, we can return immediately. So the best case is that the key would be the first element, and in this case we would need one check, and the worst case would be the key may not exist, and then we need to do n checks. Well, why do we need n checks? Well, because that's how our loop is structured. So what do you think is more important, the best case or the worst case? Right, the best case is one check, the worst case is n checks. Well, note first also that the way we organize the algorithm has an influence how many checks we need in the best and the worst case. I could have, for example, set an internal variable here, like if the key matches, then I set, you know, TMP to be value Y, and at the end I could return this temporary variable. So basically in all the cases I would have checked any location. That would be a bit, you know, suboptimal algorithm, but it would have worked. So then we would have had a best case of n and a worst case of n as well. So we talk about best case and worst case to estimate performance in this case. So the best case was really how long did our program run in the fastest case. And it's sometimes really easy to determine, but the proofs to prove such a runtime might be difficult. For, you know, best case and worst cases, right? The average case is typically rather complex to determine, and it has to consider all possible cases. And we are generally really interested in the worst and average case, because think about this case now. You want to do a purchase order in an online shop. And on average, this takes 100 milliseconds, which is, you know, you click on it, it works. But in the worst case, it would take 1 second or even 10 seconds. Would you be willing as a customer to wait that long? So is this runtime acceptable for you? I would doubt it. So that's why worst case is really, in many cases for interactive usage, particularly relevant. And now we must wonder, how do we specify the runtime in these cases in a more theoretical way? And that's exactly what today's lecture is about, to formalize a little bit this kind of analysis that we've done here.